97,000! Oh my gosh!
You guys, our family just keeps growing and growing.
Guys, we are so stoked! We cannot believe it! Those of you just recently joined, thank you! We are so close to our goal of 100,000 subscribers. I cannot believe it.
3,000 away, which is crazy! Oh my gosh, you guys, seriously.
And seriously, thank you to every single one of you guys. We cannot love and appreciate you guys more.
I know.
And if you guys have been sharing our videos, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Seriously, you guys, we woke up this morning because we've been right around almost to 90, and we were 200 away, and over this last week, it's been getting closer and closer, and we hit it and surpassed it, and you guys, welcome to Jared and Britt, those of you that are new here, and those of you that have been here since the beginning, through the years.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Thank you for continuing all the OGs,
loyal, loving it.
All the OGs when our channel got shut down after our first video.
Oh my goodness, seriously.
I actually saw a lot of comments when we did our podcast saying you should tell that story. So maybe we'll have to tell that story on one of our little story times.
Getting canceled by YouTube. Literally, that happens.
Kidding you guys, it's been a crazy few years, that is for sure. But each little thousand milestone, it feels amazing to know that people are still joining our little family here on YouTube. And we're just so grateful for each and every one of you.
Seriously, like this little community that we're like building and like, you know, all of us are building.
Yeah.
It's just so cool. We love your guys' comments. We try to respond back to as many as we can. Obviously, we can't do all. If I did it, I'd probably get canceled again.
Jared was literally responding back to every single comment that was coming in on our first
I wanted
video.
To and the thing is that YouTube thought it was a robot, and it was me literally like just going through every single comment, making sure that you guys were all loved and appreciated.
If any of you are new here, this is your first time watching, come hit that subscribe button, help us get closer to 100,000.
I know,
you guys, that is just like,
I want that little silver play button. I'm gonna just put it up right there.
So to celebrate, we thought we would all share a meal together. Today is Sunday, and so we are doing our Sunday sit down, Sunday dinner, whatever you want to call it. We're inviting you into our home.
Yes.
Into the
kitchen. Welcome. Come on in.
And we are making something new today, you guys, which I'm super excited about. Also, I'm extra excited because I'm using my new little chopper that Jared got me. Which, if you missed that
video, gift
that
keeps on giving.
Jared surprised me with a little chopper. I never had one of these. We had one growing up, like my mom did, but I never owned one. And you guys know how much chopping I do, especially on the video.
Seriously, we do a lot of cooking videos, and we were looking. A lot of you guys are actually looking for Brittany's recipes. So we hope that this little guy helps out.
Look how cool. It comes with like little containers that hold the different blades in it, which is really nice. I was kind of like, oh, where am I gonna swirl these? But it came with it, which is awesome. So I was reading kind of about it. I got everything all washed. So I think for this, we're gonna start with this little guy right here. And it even comes with, I don't have all the things out. It comes with like an egg slicer, a mandolin, a container you can actually just use, like take this off and use this and like put it in the fridge to like store it. Like say if you chop up like a little salad or whatever.
Yeah, like guacamole or something.
Yeah. There's like so many uses for it. So anyways, handy dandy thing. I'll put a link for it in case you are looking for a chopper. I'm hoping to get this one up on our website, but until then I will put the recipe down in the comments.
Yes.
But you guys, I got this out. I washed it. I have not used it yet. I was waiting for a recipe that needed a lot of chopping, and this is that recipe. And so we are making Greek chicken bowls tonight for dinner.
Yes.
So if you're a big fan of Greek, I think you'll really like this. Even if you're not, I feel like you can use this chicken recipe in a ton of different ways. So it's like a very versatile chicken. So for our little Greek bowls, you can obviously put in any of your toppings, any of your favorite things that you love. So I don't have any rice on hand right now, but I did have some orzo pasta. So I'm gonna be making some lemon orzo pasta to go with our bowl, but you could totally use rice or just do lettuce and do like more salad type things. But we are gonna do some of orzo today. So I'll show you how to make that. Also, we love Kalamata olives, so we're gonna do that. Jared's actually allergic to garbanzo beans.
So it's interesting why she's putting this in this meal today.
You know?
Trying to poison me, that's cool.
He was kind of bugging me last night, so we might just chop them up real fine and just throw them and everything. No, those are for me. And then I'm gonna dice up, well, I should say chop up, I guess, with a chopper, some red onion, cucumber, tomato, bell pepper, and then I'm gonna be making a really yummy dressing to go with it that you can use if you do want to do it Greek style. And then these are our seasonings for our little chicken bites we're going to be air frying. But before we get to chopping, first step is our chicken. So you could, I'm gonna air fry this. You could obviously just cook it on the stove or in the oven. But basically I have three chicken breasts here and I'm going to season them heavily. Ooh. So I have garlic powder, I have some garlic salt, some paprika, some lemon pepper, and then I'm gonna use salt and pepper as well, and then a little cornstarch. So I saw this video and a girl said if you're air frying and you add in a little cornstarch, it makes it a little more crispy. So we can try that out and see if that is true.
I like my chicken crispy.
Oh yeah, who doesn't like a little crispy bite? All right, so before I get to my chicken, I'm gonna drop my orzo pasta, and then I'm actually gonna cube up my chicken. I'm not gonna show that on camera, because I don't think you don't like raw chicken.
Yeah.
I don't like raw meat. So I'll do that and then I'll show you what we do next. All right, so I have my orzo going. I got my chicken all chopped up. I don't know about you guys, but I do not love handling raw meat, but I got it chopped up just into like, think of like little chicken nugget bites almost. And now I'm just gonna season. I'm not really measuring, I know I probably should, but literally I'm just gonna, this is some garlic powder. Then we got some garlic salt. And honestly, you can use whatever flavorings you like, but we're gonna do it pretty generously. And the cool thing about this, I'm not gonna use all this chicken for today. This is a lot of chicken. I'm gonna actually save it, and then we can have it like for lunch or whatever tomorrow, or just like, you know, we need some more protein. So I am gonna just try and cook it in probably two batches because our air fryer isn't huge. Oh, I should have put my spices in one place so I know which ones I've used. Okay, I've used those. We got some lemon pepper. You guys know I love lemon pepper. It's one of our faves.
It's delicious.
And then some good old black pepper. And then we'll do some of this cornstarch. I'm really curious to see if this makes a difference. I'll just kind of do this.
You can tell this is the first time for us.
You know, we're just doing it. That's how it is.
We're making a mistake, so you don't have to.
Should I use my hands?
Yeah. Get in there, baby, with those new nails.
You guys, I'm sorry. Fast forward if you don't like this part, but that is the best way to get like all the seasoning, I feel like.
We'll do it from afar.
Yeah, do it from afar. Oh, I just had the best idea. I should have put all of this into a Ziploc, then put this back, and then like massaged it like that. I just spent a few minutes washing my hands. Maybe do that if you have one of those. I actually had Jared, as I turned it, he actually put on a little bit more spices too, so it's nice and coated. And then I sprayed this with some cooking spray, and now I'm gonna just put it into my air fryer. I got these little parchment air fryer liners, and they've been awesome. One thing though, to keep in mind, if you do get them, make sure you don't preheat it without any food on there, because they will, I've heard, burn. So that's a little tip there. And then you also need to make sure there's enough food to like hold it down too. I'm gonna pop these in the air fryer probably at 400 for about 8 to 10 minutes. We'll just watch them. Okay, our orzo is done, so I'm gonna go ahead and hurry and drain this so it doesn't get overcooked. A little facial. Steam facial.
Orzo pasta is like some of my favorite ever. It tastes so good.
So we're gonna keep that pan, and we're gonna just drain off the water, and then you guys, we're gonna keep this super simple. I'm just gonna add in some fresh lemon juice and a little bit of olive oil to this. And that's it, because the little dressing sauce I'm gonna make will flavor this and be really good with it. I am gonna put some olive oil on it just so it doesn't stick together, and then the lemon juice, and then we'll be ready to use it. You do not need to use this. I think this will just give some delicious flavor to our bowl, but this is a simple Greek dressing. So we're gonna use oregano, some Dijon, a little bit of olive oil or avocado oil, red wine vinegar, some honey, salt and pepper, and garlic. So super simple. I'll put the recipe down below, but I'm gonna get this all thrown into a blender, or you can just whisk it together if you want, but I like to blend it. And our chicken is almost done. It smells so good.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, you guys, our chicken is done. You gotta come check this out. It looks really, really good. Look at the color on that, and then should we break one open and see if it's juicy? One little tip, I'm gonna actually let the rest sit. Ooh, you see that?
Looks good.
Look at that juice right there. So if you did need to cut them, I would wait like 5 minutes just so those juices can stay trapped in there so they don't leak out. But I also like to, right while they're still hot, finish with a little more salt and pepper just so you know, give them that little bite. Should we do our tomato first?
Let's do it.
All right, so.
These are little small tomatoes. Maybe it would work better with a bigger one, but let's just give it a whirl. Okay.
All right.
I feel like it's gonna like squeeze out. Oh,
I don't
no.
know. I guess we'll find out. Hard? Push it hard. Ooh.
Wow. I was so perfect. Nervous it was gonna like squeeze all over me.
Look at this. Okay, I'll try five. Let's try that. This is so weird.
That is crazy. This is so cool, and it gets them perfectly.
All right, next up we have our bell pepper.
That's perfect.
You guys, this is awesome. You can get any aggression out.
All your aggression out.
Perfectly cut. This is such a game changer for me.
Okay, guys, I'm not sure on the cucumber how big of a piece. Is that too big? Do I need to like make it thinner? Let me know. We're gonna give it a shot. Okay.
Ooh, okay. 1, 2, 3.
Oh my gosh.
That was good.
That was perfect.
Okay, they're a little big, so I think I'm gonna do it a little bit like that maybe. Let's try this one.
Oh, oh my gosh, this is so cool.
That is incredible.
Look at that though, all my veggies are chopped. Okay, now the one I'm most excited about is the onion.
Ooh yeah.
So I am gonna switch out this blade, I think, for the tinier one, so let's give that a try.
3, 2.
Ooh.
Oh my gosh, are you kidding me? You guys, no wow. more prying.
Look at that
no
perfect
more.
Dice.
I know, look at that perfect little dice. Okay, 3. You do have to use a little more force on the onion. Let's see.
Well, I think it's because it's smaller, like squares.
Yeah.
Look at this perfectly minced, diced, whatever you want to call it, onion.
We even did our olives in there, which is awesome. So I have everything chopped up. Now, usually we use like a tzatziki, and I thought I had some in our fridge, but we don't. But I do have plain Greek yogurt, and then I'm going to just add some lemon to it. Because I feel like with any Greek dish, you gotta have like a tzatziki mm-hmm. creamy type sauce. So I'm literally just gonna do that and some salt and pepper. And that's gonna be our little creamy sauce to go with it.
It's pretty healthy.
Okay, so before I dish up mine, figured, you know, let you guys dish up your bowl first.
Oh yeah, will you guys hand me your plate or bowl? Oh, thank you, perfect. Okay, so do you want, I assume you want some orzo.
We'll do some mm-hmm. orzo in there. What else would you like on it?
Let's grab some more little chicken bites. How many pieces would you like?
Four, you guys say?
No, way more than four. We'll do like 10.
You don't like onion or you do like onion?
I
think most of you are screaming you do like onion. So we're gonna give you some onion.
Deal.
We got some cucumber for you. Sorry, I'm using my hands, you guys. We're all family here though,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, right?
We got some
hands are washed, we're good.
Scoop of tzatziki right in the middle right there.
Oh, that looks delicious. Good choices, you guys.
Our dressing. You want over the
yeah.
orzo?
Okay. Yeah, I love that.
We'll do a little bit over the orzo, maybe a little bit over the chicken.
Wow, our table got a lot bigger with thousands sitting here. With...
Is this the biggest dinner party you've ever been to?
Yeah. Guys, we're excited.
Should we cheers to 97,000?
You!
Oh, and Finny's down here. You can't see him, but he's literally, I gotta show you guys really quick. There he is, right there.
This looks and smells delicious. Can't wait to take the first bite. Yeah. Actually, we'll let you guys go ahead.
Yeah. Oh, Jared, where are our manners? Sorry. Napkins on our laps.
Yeah.
My gosh.
Guess go first. All right, how'd you guys like it? Pretty good?
Taking a bite? Let's see, yeah. I gotta mix it all around so we get like a little bit of everything. Chicken pieces are a little bit big.
I love these Sunday sit-downs. They're so good. That was really good with the vegetables. It is very delicious. In fact, one of the things that kind of makes me pretty, you know, stoked about this is because Brittany and I were watching a show last night. I don't remember the name of it. Actually, no, it's called Blue Zones on Netflix. Mm-hmm. And it was about how these people reached the age of 100. They called them centenarians.
Centenarians, I believe that's over 100.
Yeah.
Like century-year-old.
Yeah, so people that, you know, gotten over 100 years old. And it was basically researching, like, all the things that they have that are, like, similarities. And one of the number one things, he went to, like, a ton of different countries. He went to, like, Japan, he went to Italy. He even, like, studied, like, different types of, like, religions. Anyway, but one of the things that he said that they all had in common is that they prepare their own food.
Yeah, like no preservatives, yeah. No like packaged foods. It's all like homegrown, fresh food. No matter what it was, really. Like, even like in Italy, they were saying, because they eat a lot of pasta and carbs, but it's all homemade.
Yeah.
And then Japan, they were eating like a lot of different vegetables and sweet potatoes.
Yeah, it was so interesting to see, like, you know, so many different types of like eating and then like cuisines and all that sort of thing. Like Brittany was saying, like one, it was like eating carbs, and like everyone just thinks like, no, don't eat carbs. Like don't.
Yeah.
Because it was being prepared by them. It was like super like healthy for them. Like heart was functioning way better than like anything. Like
a lot less diseases.
A lot less diseases, no heart failure, no lower cholesterol. Same thing over in Japan where they're eating like mainly vegetables.
Yeah, tons of veggies and like tofu and stuff like that. Yeah. So it was kind of inspiring, really cool to think about.
Very
also,
cool, yeah.
Another thing is like they're always moving. So like if they were living in villages and there were like steep inclines or gardening, like these little cute old people are like bending down, gardening, and they're like flexible and they're...
It was crazy to think about. Yes, and it was very crazy because he talks about like there was like a little animation that he showed and said about how much time we spend sitting down, and it showed like this animation of this guy sitting, and he said, you know, we sit in our cars when we drive to work, and then we sit at our desk while we're working, then we sit back in our cars to go back home, then we sit when
we're... our recliners and our seats.
Yeah, and then you lay back down to go to sleep, and then you just repeat that process the next day.
Yeah.
And it was just like mind-blowing and so eye-opening to me. It's just like, wow, we spend a lot of time sitting.
Yeah, so what that means is we're actually going to stand now to eat. You guys are going to see us standing a lot. Our Sunday sit-downs are now going to be running.
Marathons as we're
stand-up Sunday dinners. Yeah. That's what it's gonna turn into. But it's just something to like, it was crazy to like just keep in mind, like, oh my gosh, just like doing things like that and changing those little habits each day really does make a difference, at least according to all the studies there. So
you know,
if you haven't seen it, we recommend that. We always love talking about different shows and things like
that. It was really good. It's like, it makes me think about like this sort of thing, like especially with how easy it is now to like chop up vegetables or pretty much anything inside that thing.
Bam, bam, bam.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lot easier and more fun to like make quick meals on our own.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, did you guys pass the pepper?
Oh yeah, sorry. That'd be cool. Sarah, you're hogging the salt.
That's the salt, actually.
Sarah, didn't you know this is salt, not pepper? Oh, thank you. Sorry, that was kind of rude. Was I rude to my guests?
Hope you guys come back. Oh, you guys, you want this back? All right, here you go. There you go.
Oh, thank you. Oh my gosh. Okay, so that is one TV show we've watched. We want to know, what are some shows or movies that you've seen that you really liked? Comment down below, because I feel like everyone's always looking for different shows or movies to watch. So comment down below. We also watched Tarzan, that's on Netflix right now.
Mm-hmm.
We had never seen it. It's an old movie. But
so it's like a...
Loved it.
Yeah, I thought it was really good too. You know, like the Tarzan, like the animated version with Disney, I think, made it? It's not like that at all.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, so I was actually really kind of like taken off guard. I was like, wait a second, I know the story of Tarzan. This is not it. But it was really good. I liked it.
Mm. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm just eating my dirt talking. It's so good though.
Yeah, it is really, really delicious.
This is one, put on your list, especially if you're a fan of Greece.
Whatever you put in like the chicken, that little like white powder stuff.
I forget,
that
corn starch.
Yeah, it's made like crispy.
And it's juicy, it's so delicious. Mm-hmm. But we can use this chicken in like lots of different dishes. Mm-hmm. But all the spices and everything kind of bring it together. So hopefully you guys are enjoying it. And then after this, I think you guys were on dessert again. So
yes. That ice cream you guys brought last time, amazing. Thank you.
So good. You're welcome to our house anytime, as long as you're having dessert. You guys know this.
I'm actually curious, would you guys like to see a dessert recipe?
Ooh, yeah.
That's something we've never tried before.
Maybe we do a dessert instead of a dinner.
Yeah.
Kind of every now and then. Yeah. We can kind of change it up a little bit. But you guys, we hope you enjoyed our little Sunday sit down celebration video. Thanks for coming to dinner with us. Thanks for coming into our house. Yeah, we are excited. We got a lot of fun things ahead. Speaking of that, we actually have some more people that are going to be joining us here for dinner.
Very soon.
Coming up, so stay tuned for that. But
lots to prepare for.
Yeah, with that, we're going to go ahead and close out today's video. Thanks for coming and eating with us. And
we'll see you guys next time.
See you next time.
Love you. Bye.
Bye.